Hi, this is Changla. I am in Changla Pass. This is the fourth highest motorable pass in the world.
Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel Swami Vijay, and this is Swami Vijay speaking to all. In this video, I am going to start one more lesson from your Honeydew textbook. But before I start the lesson, let me ask you one question as usual. Can you tell me which is the deepest lake in the world on planet Earth? Come on, quick. I know you're all Googling. Google it fast. And if you know the answer, comment in the comment section below. Which is the deepest lake on the planet Earth? Yes, the answer is correct. Lake Baikal is the deepest lake on the planet Earth. One more question before I start the lesson. Give me the name of the highest peak on planet Earth. Yes, the answer is correct. Mount Everest is the highest mountain peak on planet Earth. Can you tell me the height of the Mount Everest? Of course, the height of the Mount Everest differs from summer season to winter season. But approximately, if you know the answer, the height of the Mount Everest, comment in the comment section below. Is it easy to reach Mount Everest, top of the Mount Everest? Is it easy? It is very tough. There were so many people that tried, and very less number of people succeeded to reach the top of the Mount Everest. And in the process of reaching the Mount Everest, so many people have lost their lives also. So climbing Mount Everest is one of the most dangerous trek in this world. The name of the story which I am going to start from your main textbook, Honeydew textbook, in this video is The Summit Within, written by Major HPS Ahluwalia. In this story, Major HPS Ahluwalia explains how difficult it was to climb the Mount Everest, and once he reached the top of the Mount Everest, how he felt and what exactly he felt. We believe that to climb the Mount Everest or to summit the Mount Everest, it not only needs the physical strength, it needs even mental strength also. That means people who are physically and mentally strong, they could only complete climbing Mount Everest. I'm going to give you the summary of the lesson very quick. Major HPS Ahluwalia was a member of the first successful Indian expedition to Mount Everest in 1965. How did he feel when he stood on the highest point in the world? Let us hear his story in his words. Climbing the summit and then the more difficult task of climbing the summit within. Here there are two summits, summit outside and summit which is inside. Summit outside, here we can understand it is the Mount Everest. Climbing Mount Everest is very difficult. In the same way, we have to summit within. What is the summit we are having inside us? Our own fears. Let us understand how to summit the fears inside and how to conquer ourselves. The most important thing is conquering the heights in the physical world is not as difficult as conquering our fears in our mind. Of all the emotions which surged through me as I stood on the summit of Everest, looking over miles of panorama below us, the dominant one I think was humility. When HPS Ahluwalia reached the Mount Everest, top of the Mount Everest or the top of the world, he felt humility. What is the meaning of the word humility? Humility means the quality of having a modest or low view of one's importance. Before climbing the summit, Mount Everest, he must have thought about himself in a different way. But once he reached the height of the Mount Everest, when he looked down the earth from the Mount Everest, he felt humility. He understood how small and how powerless he is after climbing the Mount Everest. The feeling and emotion in HPS Ahluwalia after climbing the Mount Everest was humility. The physical in me seemed to say, thank God, it's all over. So he believed that without the support of the God, he couldn't climb Mount Everest and he couldn't successfully reach the Mount Everest. However, instead of being jubilant, there was a tinge of sadness. Was it because I had already done the ultimate in climbing and there would be nothing higher to climb and all roads hereafter would lead down? This is a little surprise to understand. After climbing Mount Everest, the author was feeling that there is no any other summit which is higher than Mount Everest. Hereafter, everything is smaller than Mount Everest. By climbing the summit of Everest, you are overwhelmed by a deep sense of joy and thankfulness. It is a joy which lasts a lifetime. The experience changes you completely. The man who has been to the mountains is never the same again. It is believed that people who travel to mountain, they will never return same. That means
look
these
back.
Mountains, traveling through mountains, will bring a lot of change in their personality. In the next paragraphs of the story, we'll come to know that climbing to a summit shows the climber's willpower, physical and mental strength, endurance and persistence. And why HPAJ Ahluwalia wanted to climb Mount Everest? Because it was his childhood dream. Since childhood, the narrator has been attracted by mountains. According to him, mountains have a challenging beauty and majesty. But if anybody asks him, why Mount Everest only? The answer is simple. Why Everest? Because it is the highest, the mightiest, and has defied many previous attempts. It takes the last ounce of one's energy. It is a brutal struggle with rock and ice. Once taken up, it cannot be given up halfway, even when one's life is at stake. The passage back is as difficult as the passage onwards. So Ahluwalia explained that it is not easy thing for everybody to climb Mount Everest. Only people with strong willpower, determination, physically and mentally strong, they can only achieve this climbing Mountain Everest. In the next passages, Ahluwalia explained how difficult it was for him and for his entire team to climb the Mount Everest and to reach the top of the Mount Everest. But after reaching the Mount Everest, looking from the summit, you tell yourself that it was worthwhile. Others, silvery peaks appear through the clouds. If you are lucky, the sun may be on them. The surrounding peaks look like a jeweled necklace around the neck of your summit. Below, you see vast valleys sloping into the distance. It is an ennobling, enriching experience to just look down from the summit of a mountain. You bow down and make your obeisance to whichever god you worship. So Ahluwalia felt that it is not only the physical and mental strength which made him to reach the Mount Everest, it is even the blessings of God. So he and his teammates left a few things on the top of the Mount Everest. He left a picture of Guru Nanak, Rawat left a picture of Goddess Durga, Pu Dorji left a relic of the Buddha, and Edmund Hillary had buried a cross under a crane. Crane means a heap of rocks and stones. And while coming down from the Mount Everest, Ahluwalia understood that it is as difficult as climbing up. The effects of both the climbs are the same. Whether the mountain you climb is physical or emotional and spiritual, the climb will certainly change you. It teaches you much about the world and about yourself. When we struggle, when we have obstacles in life, and when we overcome the obstacles in life, it will teach us a lot of lessons and we will realize our potential and our capacity. So overcoming the obstacles is a real challenge in our life. Overcoming our fears is a real challenge in our life, and that is the summit within. So whenever problems comes in our life, we should work hard and we should try to overcome those problems and to find solution to those problems so that we can clear those obstacles and we reach our goal. So you all have to understand that summit within is our own fears and the struggle and obstacles we will come across in our life, and we should try to overcome these obstacles to become successful in our life. In the last paragraph, Ahluwalia says that I venture to think that my experience as an Everester has provided me with that inspiration to face life's ordeals resolutely. Climbing the mountain was a worthwhile experience. The conquest of the internal summit is equally worthwhile. The internal summits are perhaps higher than Everest. After climbing the Mount Everest, Ahluwalia states that or comment that climbing Mount Everest is much easier than climbing our internal summits, perhaps higher than Mount Everest. Overcoming our fears and clearing or overcoming the obstacles and problems in our life are as tough as climbing the Mount Everest. According to Ahluwalia, climbing Mount Everest is much easier than climbing or overcoming the obstacles and overcoming our fears within us. So students, you have to understand, climbing Mount Everest needs physical, mental and spiritual strength to complete that the greatest trek or greatest adventure in one's life. And in our life also, we have summit. What is that summit? Overcoming our obstacles, overcoming our fears. And these fears and these obstacles are much higher and more difficult than climbing Mount Everest. So this is the summary of the lesson, The Summit Within, written by HPES Ahluwalia. Now what you have to do is read the entire text loud, practice loud reading once or twice, and then read the text silent, practice silent reading, and come to the comprehension check questions, read the questions and read the text again, find the answers to the questions and write the answers. After completion of the comprehension check questions, come to working with the text, read the questions and write the answers. So in this way, you can complete reading and writing answers to the lesson, The Summit Within, written by Ahluwalia. In future, I am going to publish videos for all your poems and lessons from your main textbook and short stories from your supplementary textbook. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel so that you can receive latest updates of the information the moment I upload videos on YouTube. So thanks for watching this video and always remember, stay home, stay safe and stay strong. Take care.